Welcome to Seed to Life. I hope you're doing well and keeping safe. In this video, I'm going to share with you one more herb or medicinal plant that is native to Africa. The plant is considered medicinally important in traditional medicine, and many researchers are exploring its potential as a medicine for various health issues. Why just humans, but animals like chimpanzees also consume this plant when they feel sick or they get intestinal worms. In this video, we'll get introduced to African bitter leaf plant. We will see the medicinal and culinary uses of this plant. We will also find out how to grow this plant in your home garden. Like many other medicinally important plants, the research on this plant is limited. So let's find out more about this nature's gift. Let's begin. The botanical name of African bitter leaf is Vernonia amygdalina. It is also known by various names, and my apologies if I am pronouncing it wrongly, but Evoro, Onugbu, Orivo, Ithiona are some of the names, and there may be many other names. Now you can imagine why the plant is known as bitter leaf. It tastes bitter. It contains some anti-nutritional factors like alkaloids, saponins, glycosides, and tannins. And these phytochemicals, or the chemicals in the plants, they give the plant a bitter taste. Now let's look at some medicinal uses of bitter leaf plant. The leaves and root extracts or decoction is used as a traditional remedy for fever, diarrhea, hiccups, kidney problems, and malaria. Infusion of the roots are used for the treatment of intestinal worms. This remedy is not only used by humans to cure themselves and their livestock, but as I mentioned earlier, also by chimpanzees who use the leaves to get rid of the intestinal worms. The plant is used as a natural medicine for treating malaria. The leaves are believed to be useful in treating various infections and sores. The plant is also believed to be effective against diabetes, snake bite, and cancer. Bitterleaf plant is a good source of dietary fibers, proteins, various minerals like calcium, magnesium, potassium, sodium, manganese, iron, zinc, and copper. Some of these nutrients and anti-nutrients are lost when the leaves are processed, so squeeze washing and cooking can reduce the efficacy of these phytochemicals. Water content of the leaves is more than 80%. I always try to find out both good and bad effects of consuming any new plant. The research on the side effects of the bitterleaf plants is very limited. If grown in the soil contaminated with heavy metals, the plant may absorb these harmful chemicals and it can cause side effects. It can also cause allergic reactions and other side effects due to anti-nutritional factors. But other than that, there is not much information available at this time. In my opinion, if something is that potent as a medicine, then it has to have at least some side effects, and it should be consumed with care. I hope in future all plants will be studied in more detail for their good and bad effects both. Till then, I believe, like other leafy vegetables, it is okay to enjoy the vegetable in moderation. Here is nutritional composition of Vernonia amygdalina or African bitter leaf per 100 gram. If you are interested in finding more information, I'm posting the links in description. I hope after learning about this plant, you feel like growing it now. Now let's see the growing requirements for bitter leaf plant. I purchased this plant from a local nursery, and so far it has been acting like a good child, growing very fast. African bitter leaf plants can be propagated by seeds as well as cuttings. Seed germination time is about 2 to 3 weeks. If you get your hands on the seeds and want to grow these plants from seeds, then make sure to keep the soil moist. The faster and easier way to propagate these plants is to grow them from cuttings. Here you can see my plant is still very young. I took a cutting of approximately 6 to 8 inches long from this plant. I removed all the big leaves, leaving only 2 top ones. And next, I will drop the cutting in clean water. You can keep the cutting next to a sunny window, partial shade, or under a grow light. I am going to use grow light because the outside temperature keeps on changing and I don't want to ruin the cutting. After the root buds start appearing on the stems, I will plant them in soil. The soil has to be well draining but also should retain moisture since the plant loves moist soil and grows well in it. According to some studies, as the acidity of the soil, that means the organic content increases, the heavy metal concentration also increases. So make sure to give the plant a good compost meal on a regular basis. African bitterleaf is a sun-loving plant. It is native to Africa, so I doubt that it will tolerate frost. Considering that it is grown in Nigeria, it is safe to assume that the bitterleaf plant prefers tropical climate. So if winters are harsh in your region, then you can either keep the plant potted and bring it inside for overwintering or be ready to lose it during winter. A mature tree looks like a small tree or a tall shrub. It can grow up to a height of 3 meters. These plants grow faster in the rainy season and you can harvest a lot of leaves during springtime. You can keep pruning this plant frequently to induce new and more shoots. Older plants produce fewer leaves than the young ones. African farmers harvest the leaves and dry them. You can find the dried leaves in online shops or international food markets near you. They are used in soups and other medicinal remedies. The paste of these leaves is applied to wounds like an antiseptic. The leaves are ground or chopped and cooked with meat, shrimps, and chopped peanuts. For consuming, young shoots are preferred because they taste less bitter compared to the leaves from the mature stems. So it depends on your taste preference how you like them. The plant can last for up to 7 years. Leaves are spindle-shaped, they are perfectly symmetrical and somewhat velvety in texture. They can easily get bruised and have no smell. The flowers are white in color and form in clusters near the ends of the shoots. So far, this is what I know about this plant. Now, if you want to hang out with me while I prepare this healthy black leaf soup with longevity spinach and shrimps, then you're welcome to stay. This is the first time I'll be making this soup. Today, I'm not going to follow the traditional recipe very accurately, but I'm going to mix it up a little bit. I don't have all the ingredients and so I have to do this compromise. Also, I'm making very small batch since these leaves are very bitter and I don't have meat. Not sure how it will turn out. So let's start. For this recipe, I'm using 7 to 8 black leaves, 1/2 to 3/4 cup of longevity spinach leaves, 3 to 4 cloves of garlic, 4 green chilies, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1/4 cup of peanuts, 1/2 cup of salad shrimps, salt and water. Step 1 is to wash the leaves multiple times to remove the bitterness as much as possible. We are going to lose some important nutrients while washing, but I know my taste buds are not adapted to that much bitterness. And also we have to get rid of the anti-nutritional factors. The leaves are almost crushed. Step 2 is to either chop all the leaves or you can also grind them if you like. I'm going to grind them today. Then step 3 is to make a paste of garlic and green chilies. Step 4 is to roast the peanuts in a little bit of oil and chop them up or grind them into a chunky paste. Step 5 is to heat 1 to 2 teaspoon of oil and add a teaspoon of cumin seeds and let it splutter for a few seconds to release the aroma. In step 6, I will add garlic and green chili paste and fry it a little bit to remove the raw flavor. Next, in step 7, I'm adding some shrimps and frying them. You can add meat at this time, the cooked meat, not the raw meat, but you have to fry it first and then add it. Step 8 is to add the ground leaves of bitterleaf. Here, they're mixed with longevity spinach. In step 9, you have to add salt and let it cook for 5 to 7 minutes. The cooking time will change depending on your choice of meat. In step 10, you add peanuts and we are all set.
Our soup is ready. If you like healthy recipes, you will surely like this soup. You will feel the bitter aftertaste, but it is very mild to negligible. I like bitter foods like bitter gourd and fenugreek, so I love this soup. I will surely try it again.
I hope you liked learning about one more new plant. Feel free to share your experiences if you already have this plant in your home garden and use it for cooking. I would love to know more about it.
Big thanks for watching my videos. Please subscribe to my channel Seed to Life and share my videos. Video links are posted in the description. See you again. Bye.